That was a beautiful song. Like, literally one of the best new songs I've listened to. Taylor Swift and Kanye West, two of the most prominent religious figures of the 21st century. They also happen to be two of the most popular musical artists of all time. And for some reason, they've been beefing with each other for over a decade.
I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish.
And this has led to their fan bases going to all-out war. Now, I would consider myself a pretty big Kanye West fan. I've listened to all of his discography, including a lot of his unreleased music, and I followed his career pretty closely, but I wouldn't say that I hate Taylor Swift. I honestly really know nothing about her. I've listened to some of her pop songs on the radio, but that's pretty much it. So today, I'm gonna be listening to one of Taylor Swift's albums to give my honest opinion as a Kanye West fan. Now, Taylor Swift has a bunch of albums, but the one I decided to listen to was Folklore, because on basically every list online, that is ranked as her best album. All right, track one is titled The One. Let's go for it.
I thought I saw you at the bus stop, I didn't though.
Dang, I really like the subdued beat and the simple chord progression. I think it complemented her vocals pretty well. That was actually a really enjoyable song. As far as the actual content of her lyrics, it's like breakup music. It's kind of what I expected. But honestly, that's like a really strong start. I enjoyed that song. Next one is called Cardigan.
Assume you know nothing. You put me on and said I was your favorite.
It feels like the instrumental is like simple, but I know there's so many layers to it. Like, I hear the piano, but there's so many different percussions in the background. It really pops out.
Everything when I was young, I knew I'd curse you for the longest time.
All right, just finished Cardigan. So far, she's 2 for 2. Cardigan is a really good song, and I noticed there's actually a narrative to the song, and I actually did some research, and apparently there's a narrative to the entire album. There's like a love triangle between three characters, so I'm gonna pay attention to that moving forward. Next up, we got The Last Great American Dynasty.
Salt box house on the coast, took a mind off St. Louis. The loudest woman this town has ever seen.
All right, The Last Great American Dynasty. Pretty good song. That one was a little more pop than the first two, but still pretty enjoyable. Next up, we got Exile.
So what am I defending now? You were my town. Now I'm in exile, seeing you out.
I just realized that's Justin Vernon, and he also collabs with Kanye a lot, so interesting connection.
So I'm leaving at the side door.
So step right out.
Okay, I got a bunch of thoughts after that one. At first, I didn't actually like this song that much, but as it went on, I kind of understood what the lyrics were talking about. Basically, I think it's like a couple reconnecting after they broke up. So it was a nice little story there. But one thing I realized is like, I really felt like listening to the song, like I was a white girl living in a Colorado suburb. I don't know what it is, but I felt like I was just transported into a completely different place. Anyways, pretty enjoyable song. But let's move on to My Tears Ricochet.
We get the here, we line up, we've been in a sunlit room.
One thing I'm pleasantly surprised by so far listening to this album is that Taylor Swift is a really good songwriter, because from most of the pop songs I've listened to, it's really basic, bland lyrics, but so far she's been coming in with some pretty fire bars.
Wishing I stayed, look at how my tears ricochet fall.
I feel like teenage girls probably feel about this song the same way I feel about Heartless by Kanye, but My Tears Ricochet, it's alright. Not my favorite so far, but next up we got Mirror Ball. Very interesting title there. Hold up, she's a disco ball? I'm not sure if I'm really messing with the mirror ball metaphor, I'm gonna be honest, but the production was outstanding on that song. I'm really loving the whole like small town vibe of this album. Yeah, next up is Seven. Hopefully it's a banger. Let's go. Oh my, I already know I'm gonna like this one.
Scream ferociously.
That was a beautiful song. Like, literally one of the best new songs I've listened to recently. Like, production was amazing, very low-key, but also kind of haunting. The whole narrative of her talking to her friend about how she grew up in, like, an abusive house was really chilling, and her vocals are really nice. Like, that is definitely going to be added to the rotation. W song, like, 7, so far, by far, my favorite song on the album. Chef's kiss. Next up, we got August.
Whispers of "Are you sure?" Back when we were still changing for the better, you were my lose. No. But I...
Wait, so hold up. She's with the dude who's in a relationship, I guess? Huh.
In case you call, back when I was living for the hope of it all.
A nice chill song about a girl, I guess, getting with a married man or something, but pretty nice vibe to the song. Next up, we got "This Is Me Trying." Sounds like... Damn, that sounds like some Frank Ocean type stuff.
Didn't know if you'd care if I came back. I have a lot of regrets about that.
Bro, like, there's so much reverb on her voice. It sounds like I'm at prom in, like, a small town high school in, like, the middle of nowhere, and she's, like, performing this in, like, the venue hall or whatever. But honestly, like, this album is really good at, like, transporting me into a completely different world.
I got wasted, like, all my potential, and my words should...
Oh, damn. I got wasted, like, all my potential. That's a bar, bro. That is a bar.
Pouring out my heart to a stranger, but I didn't pour the whiskey.
I love that song. That was fire. Production was tremendous. Her voice was tremendous. Pretty catchy chorus. Next up, we got "Illicit Affairs."
Oops. Ends with meetings in parking lots. And that's the thing about illicit affairs.
Hold up, we got another cheating song? All right, babe.
You leave no trace behind, like you don't even exist.
I guess this time she's cheating.
Baby, look at this godforsaken mess that you made me.
Illicit Affairs, it's all right. Not my favorite song so far. I'm sure a lot of you can relate to it. Anyways, next up we got "Invisible String." "Invisible String," W song. The guitar loop was really nice, and I really like the, like, love story element to the lyrics. That song felt like it belongs as, like, the end credit scene of, like, an indie movie. But anyways, next up we got "Mad Woman."
What did you think I'd say to that? Does a scorpion sting when fighting back? It's nothing like a
good song. I agreed with the sentiment that she was singing about, but it's songs like these that make me understand why her fans bully her exes. Next up, we got "Epiphany."
Flesh wound is your rifle. Some things you just can't speak about.
One thing that has really impressed me so far about this album is the songwriting. Like, so far, my exposure to Taylor Swift songwriting is "Shake It Off," which is, you know, not exactly Shakespeare, but the whole narrative she has built throughout this album is really dope. Next up, we got "Betty."
You heard the rumors from Inez. You can't believe a word she says most.
All right, this song is definitely for, like, 13-year-old girls. Like,
only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you. Plus, I saw you dance with him. Of you when she pulled up like a big man of my worst intention. Kiss me, will it be just like I dreamed it? Will it patch your broken wings?
Okay, at first, I'm not gonna lie, I felt really awkward listening to the song because it was giving off vibes of, you know, I'm 16 and I'm deep, but I actually found myself kind of enjoying the whole story she was painting out, and Yeah, it was a really nice song. I was definitely not the target demographic for that song, but still found myself enjoying it. Next up, we got Peace. We're down to the last two songs.
Suddenly this summer it's clear. I never had the courage of my convictions. Your integrity makes me seem small. You paint dreamscapes on the wall. Details, but you got a friend in me.
It seemed like a really personal song, but her vocals were really nice. Like, low-key, Taylor Swift's vocals are pretty underrated. At least on this album, she's been really showing them off. Now we're down to the very last song, Hoax. So far, pretty enjoyable album. Let's see if this last song changes anything.
No other sadness in the world would do my best lay.
That little da-da-da when the piano loops, fire.
Sadness in the world would do.
Wow, that was a great ending. Very melancholic, but I love that song. So, closing thoughts on Folklore by Taylor Swift from a Kanye West fan. That album, I would rate a very good out of 10. I found it a very consistently high quality album throughout, and it makes me excited. Like, I kind of want to check out some of her other stuff after listening to this album. It's a completely different type of music than I'm used to, but I think it executes its job very well, and it paints this like really small town vibe. Like, I know I keep saying small town vibe, but that's just what keeps coming up in my head. Like, a small town where there's like one high school and everyone knows each other. That's kind of the vibe I get from this album. And yeah, I really like it. After listening to this album, would I consider myself a full-time Swiftie? And will I go and defend her on Twitter for 24 hours a day? Probably not, but I really did genuinely like this album, and there were some songs that I truly loved, like Seven. That song is so fire. And there's a couple songs that from this album that are definitely gonna go into my rotation. But yeah, if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and check out some of my other videos. I got so many more on the way, and why be better? Peace.